hear the truth. You know? Amen. Therefore, we can't hear the truth. We can't be held accountable to
my Lord Jesus.
Yeah, no, because I didn't hear. I didn't hear. You heard when Minister Blaine said, "No, I ain't him. I was in the spirit." No, you weren't.
No, you weren't.
You were trying to avoid hearing what was being said. Praise the name of the Lord. Let's finish this up, brother.
Thank you, Lord Jesus.
You can do all that, but if you have not love, all that stuff is a bunch of noise.
Yes.
Come on.
And though I have the gift of prophecy.
Though I have the gift of prophecy.
And understand all mysteries.
And I understand mysteries. Mm-hmm.
And all knowledge.
And I have knowledge.
And though I have all faith.
And I have faith.
So that I could remove mountains.
To the point where I could move mountains.
And have not charity.
And have not love.
I am nothing.
God still
nothing.
Says you're nothing.
Nothing.
Amen. You can prophesy till you're blue in the face. You can see mysteries till you're blue in the face. You can move mountains all day long. But after all that has been said and done, and God looks at your love. He looks at your love, and your love is not measuring up to his love. God's going to say all that was vain.
Mm-hmm.
All that was nothing. Y'all hear what I'm saying?
Amen. That's the word.
That's why God don't care about our coming here. He does not care about our coming here and our singing and our routine and our calling on Jesus and doing all this type of stuff. When he looked at the most important stuff and see that you're not measuring up, he throws all that stuff in the trash.
Amen. Amen.
To God, God will say, all that meant nothing to me. You sung beautifully. You prayed heaven down. But I'm looking at your love. And you can't even show your brother and sister love.
My Lord.
Amen. What did the Lord say? What?
My Lord.
And though I bestow all my goods to feed the poor.
And I give.
My Lord.
And though I
do you give love?
Mm-hmm.
Amen.
Amen.
We boast in what we're giving, but do you give love?
Mm-hmm.
And I gave all my goods to the poor.
And though I give my body to be burned.
And I can even give my body as a sacrifice to somebody else.
And have not charity.
And I still don't have no love.
It profiteth me nothing.
It
nothing.
Profits me absolutely nothing. Do you know that people give, but they're not giving out of love?
Amen. Amen.
So God said he loves a cheerful giver.
Mm-hmm.
One that's not giving out of a grudgingly or out of necessity. But God loves a cheerful giver. Everybody ain't giving cheerfully.
Amen.
Some folks giving grudgingly. Why I gotta get this money?
How much is it?
If it's a charity, I think should have took care of me and give extra money. You giving grudgingly. And you know what, a situation like that, God said, you might as well keep your
money. Might as well keep it. That's right.
Because guess what he's going to say he's going to do? He's not going to bless you.
No. Nope.
God ain't going to bless you with that attitude.
Mm-mm.
If you give freely, let me make this small disclaimer. If you give freely, God will give it back to you.
Yeah.
Pressed down, shaking together, turn it over.
Mm-hmm.
Some people have been giving for a long time and don't know and sit there wondering why they ain't been blessed.
Mm-mm-mm.
When I give my money, I've been giving and it seems like I just can't get no breakthrough. Well, maybe you need to check out the heart condition.
Amen.
That you had when you came.
Uh-huh. That's
y'all
right.
Y'all know when it's time for offering, you should have a big smile on your face.
Yeah.
Some of y'all walk to the offering table, man.
That's the truth, Pastor.
What you mad for?
Yeah.
God said you love a cheerful giver. Put a smile on your face.
Amen.
Give your little dollar and happy.
Amen.
You don't want to give it a dollar anyway. Let's be glad about giving that dollar.
Amen.
Man, I'm giving the dollars. God said, do it cheerfully. You should be happy to give unto the Lord.
That's right.
Happy to give to the work of the ministry. You should be glad. Folks should be happy that they ain't got to come into a church and I have a bunch of candles everywhere.
That's right. Amen.
Right to the building. You should be happy to give.
Amen.
That's right. Yeah, glad about it. Folks give to the Lord, man. You know, you're doing it grudgingly.
Yeah.
Why they asking for more money? What you mean why we asking for more? We need it.
Amen.
What you gonna call? Wow. Every time we turn around, it's something else. You right? It is something else.
That's right.
The wall falling down. What you mean? It is something else.
That's right.
Every time you turn around, it's something else. Yeah. Oh, they all had asking for money. What they doing with it? What you mean what we doing with it?
My Lord.
Trying to keep the lights on. Trying to keep the water on.
That's right.
Amen. What you doing with it? What? What
you doing with it? That was a liar.
Might be stealing the money. Uh-huh. Oh, you ain't giving enough to steal.
Amen. That's right.
Oh, Lord, I'm going up here with my father.
Come on, preacher.
People trip me out, boy. People act like they're giving multi-million dollars, you know, like you can sneak away a couple of thousand. And ain't nothing but $40 in there. If you steal 20, it's going to be noticeable. We give happily
Amen.
To the things of God. Yes. Amen. Cheerfully. You know, God ain't worried about you. Your attitude is what matters to God.
Yes.
That's why we preach. Have a good attitude. You know, be happy, be positive, because God looks at that. God looks at it. God looks at the attitude that you do everything with.
Yes.
Everybody's intention. Are going to be made manifested before God.
That's right.
Don't y'all know that everybody that preaches the gospel is not even preaching the gospel out of sincerity?
That's right.
In the book of Philippians, the Apostle Paul said, there are some people that are preaching to add affliction to my bonds. Yeah. He said, one preach Christ out of sincerity, one preach Christ out of being arrogant and envious of the gospel that we're preaching. So they're now trying to duplicate what we're doing. He said, folks are doing it just because they just want to do it. He said, but nevertheless, one thing I rejoice over is that Christ is being preached.
Yes.
But everybody's intentions for why they're preaching the gospel is not pure. Some people preach the gospel because they want something material out of it. Some folks just want to have a father. Some folks just want to be a big bishop that has a whole lot of churches and all this crazy stuff. So they're doing it out of ill intent. Mm-hmm. Paul said, I don't care why they're doing it, Christ is being preached. Mm-hmm. And because of that, I greatly rejoice. Everybody's not doing everything for the right reason. Mm-hmm. So Paul said, you can give your body to be burned, but if you're not giving your body to be burned out of love, you just sacrifice your life for nothing. Amen. If you give all your possessions, but you didn't do it out of love, you just gave up all your possessions for nothing. Mm-hmm. Amen. It serves absolutely no purpose. Word say what, brother?
Charity suffereth long.
Charity, love, suffers long.
Mm-hmm. And is kind.
It suffers long. You cannot tell me that you got the love of God, but you got a quick wit.
Amen.
When it comes to people getting on your nerves.
Amen.
Oh, she gets on my nerves. I can't stand her. I'm done with them. And you got the Holy Ghost?
That's right.
Any little disagreement, I'm getting up. Well, oh, this one gets me, boy. One gets me. Man, it's somebody. You getting on somebody, and they, I'm out of here. Hold up. Get the bag, walking out. They gone. You ready to go. The Bible said, love suffers long.
Long. Amen.
You quit. Everybody walking in when you got that walkout spirit. That storm out spirit, you know. Everybody got mad. I'm out of here. Where you going?
Amen.
Learn how to sit down and suffer long.
Amen.
What if Jesus had the attitude that some of y'all got?
My Lord.
Jesus couldn't stand on that cross?
Nope.
Oh, they nailing me. They spitting on me. I'm getting down from here.
I'm out of here. My Lord.
Jesus would have raised all type of hell. Here he is, God in the flesh. Got all power in his hand. And he endured the cross. You can't even endure somebody talking about you a little bit.
Amen.
Can't endure somebody getting on your nerves a little bit. I'm walking out. Mm-hmm.
Amen.
I'm leaving the church. I ain't seeing so many people.
Yeah.
Oh, disagreeing, walking out, leaving. I'm leaving the church.
Yeah.
Because you disagree with something, they got that Donald Trump spirit. Disagreeing with something, you're fired. Get out of here.
Yeah.
Attitude. I'm on people that say they got the Holy Ghost up.
Mm-hmm.
Holy Ghost know how to suffer stuff.
Yes, yes.
Holy Ghost know how to suffer long.
Mm-hmm.
We know how to endure it. Yeah, it gets on your nerves, bother you, but you endure it. You stick it out. You work with the person. You got to have long suffering when you're dealing with sinners that come into the church. See, that's why everybody can't be an effective witness.
No.
When pains come in here, everybody can't work with them.
No, that's the truth.
That's why I watch people and certain people, I'll tell you, you got to say a newcomer, can stay away from that person.
Yeah. Yeah.
Got to, because you've been and damaged that person
mm-hmm.
before we can get the world out of them.
Amen.
See, they got to go through a detox process.
Mm-hmm.
You can't be so hasty to get them out of pants and get them out of earrings and get them from doing all this type of stuff. You got to let them detox first.
Amen.
Let the pollution get out of their system.
Amen.
Let the word get in them. Let the word penetrate them.
That's
let the
right.
word get to the root
Amen.
Of those desires that they have. And while the word is getting to it, the layers of filth will start coming off.
Yes.
Praise the name of the Lord. But you have to slip along with the people.
Mm-hmm.
You've been going to this church for 2 months and you ain't came out the pants yet. No, it might take her a year, but let the word wash her in that
Amen.
Year. And then the adventure shall come out of
That's
that
right. Amen.
Long suffering.
Right.
That's why everybody can't work with babes.
No, no, sir.
Everybody can't work with brothers coming in here that might got long hair.
Mm-hmm.
Oh, he went down in the water in the name of Jesus Christ. Brother, it's time for you to cut that hair off now.
My Lord.
Why are you going to suffer with them?
Mm-hmm.
Let them do what they're doing for a while.
Mm-hmm.
Let the word penetrate. Let the word start cleaning them up.
Reach
and then by the time they get used to it and accustomed to things,
yeah.
then when it's presented to them about their apparel and how they got to present themselves, they can entreat what you're telling them.
Amen. Amen.
And it's easy for them to start taking that stuff off.
Mm-hmm.
That's why our turnover rate in the church is as low as it is.
My Lord.
We get them in here. Get them in here. They stay for a little while. And they right back out the door. Because somebody has said something to them.
Yes, yes.
Your skirt too short.
Mm-hmm.
Why are you wearing that?
Mm-hmm.
Why are you doing? And then therefore, they only been here for 4 months.
Mm-hmm.
And in one day, you destroyed everything about them.
My Lord.
Everything, because you don't know how to suffer long.
Mm-hmm.
Love, the Bible said, love covers a multitude of
sins.
Love knows how to cover stuff.
Yes, Lord.
Love knows how to overlook stuff.
Mm-hmm.
You can't say you got love and every little thing you try to point out about the person.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
You this and you that, you this and you that. When is love going to kick in and say, let me cover some stuff?
Right, right. Amen.
You telling everybody about that person. When is love going to say, let me cover that person?
Amen.
I don't want nobody to know that they're like that.
Amen.
Let me pray until God deliver them.
Amen.
Your first thing is to expose them.
Yep.
But love knows how to cover.
Amen. Amen.
And love is not a justification or a cloak for sin.
No, no.
But love knows how to cover them until they're delivered.
Amen.
Amen. We know how to keep people's secrets and holiness.
Amen.
Amen. We don't sit and go tell the world about everybody.
That's right.
Somebody in the church struggling with something before they can get delivered from it. Everybody know what they're struggling
My
with.
My Lord.
Why everybody have to know what they're struggling with? Some struggle between that individual and God.
Mm-hmm.
If they come to you to tell you about it, you should care enough about them to conceal that matter to yourself.
Yes, Lord.
What you telling your mama for, your daddy for?
Mm-hmm.
Why is that person sin or struggle the topic of your conversation?
Amen. Amen.
Amen.
Amen.
You know it's that girl and she can't stop sleeping with that boy. That ain't none of your business.
Mm-hmm.
If they wanted somebody else to know, they would tell somebody.
That's right.
If they come to you in confidence, leave it between you and them.
That's right.
And when they're ready to expose whatever they're going through, they'll expose it.
Yes, they will.
Amen. Our job with love is to cover them.
Amen.
Amen. In order to God delivers them. That's what love will do.
Mm-hmm.
Love will do it. Word of the Lord say what, brother?
And it's kind.
And it's kind.
Charity, envy,
y'all know
love.
What kind is. Love is kind.
Amen.
Love is not mean. Love is not nasty.
Amen.
Love is kind. Amen. Love knows how to do good to people. Mm-hmm. Love knows how to let kindness spring forth. Amen. Love knows how to be kind to people. Amen. Y'all all right?
Amen.
Amen. Amen. Love knows how to be kind to people.
Amen. Amen.
Love knows how to go out of its way to do something nice for somebody.
Yes, yes.
You didn't ask me to do this, but because out of the kindness of my heart, I did it.
Yes.
And then when you do it out of the kindness of your heart, you don't want everybody to know about it.
Amen.
Amen. You don't want everybody to know, yeah, I did it.
Yeah. Amen.
Know, that was me. When you do it out of the kindness of your heart, you don't even want nobody to know about it. Mm-hmm. And even if somebody starts talking about it, put it over the floor. Well, you know, such and such a person did X, Y, and Z. You don't sit there and wave a white banner. That was me. Sometimes it's good just to sit there and don't let nobody know it was you.
Uh-huh.
Because the Bible says if you give in secretly, if you give in secret, God will reward you openly.
That's right.
See, somehow God wants to see the individual that will go behind the scenes and will give.
Amen.
Do it out of the kindness of their heart with no recognition.
Mm-hmm.
Nobody praising them for it. See, let me tell y'all something. Y'all know there's a method to my madness, and I can tell on this church. When I came here, I purposely did certain stuff.
Uh-huh.
Purposely did it. Because it was going to expose the heart of people.
Amen.
It was going to expose the heart of people. When you start telling people, such and such gave $1,000.
Mm-hmm.
See, you can kind of walk with a chip on your shoulder. You know. Oh, brother so-and-so gave $200.
Mm-hmm.
Oh, brother so-and-so gave $200. Well, since brother so-and-so gave $200, I got to outdo brother so-and-so. So I'm getting $500.
Yep, yep.
So, oh, now, sister so-and-so gave $500 now. Yeah, you gave your two, I gave five.
Mm, mm, mm.
And so now it becomes a giving match.
Uh-huh. You
know, who will be the highest giver?
Uh-huh.
And then it becomes a competition.
My
and
Lord.
So now God's sitting there looking at your competition. But the Lord said, now, let me see something. If I stop exposing the amount you give, uh-huh. Will you still give it?
Amen. Amen. Come on, preacher.
Come on,
preacher.
Amen.
Amen.
Will you still give it?
No.
And the answer is no.
That's right.
Amen.
You can go back in the books and see people that used to give big amounts. Oh, give it up. Oh, let everybody know what you give. But when you take your glory away.
Yeah. Yeah.
Take your little shine away.
Yeah.
Now you're going to zero.
Yeah.
Amen.
To my madness. See, because I'm trying to show you that God don't care nothing about that junk.
No.
Because if you won't give, you won't give whether somebody announces the number or not.
That's right. Amen.
You still won't give because you're doing it out of your heart.
Amen.
You're doing it because you love God. Mm-hmm. You want to see the ministry go forth. So you're going to give regardless if somebody announces your name or not.
Amen.
Amen. That's why when I got into the church and folks, and I would do it all the time, folks would give me a little program with an envelope in it. I would take that envelope and tell you to fill it out. Everybody fill out your name. I ain't filling out nothing.
Right, right.
Put that money in that envelope and I give it.
Amen.
You ain't got to know my name and address. I'm giving it to the Lord. You ain't got to send me no thank you card.
Right.
I'm doing it because I love the Lord.
Amen.
You ain't got to know my address and say thank you for your liberal giving. I'm giving because I love the Lord.
Amen.
And I trust that the work that is going on here is in truth. I'm willing to give.
Mm-hmm.
Mm-hmm. Amen. You don't have to tell me how much to give either.
No.
$100 line, $20 line, $50 line. You know what? I said, and nobody lied.
Amen.
And I can be wondering in my mind, say, you know what? I'm going to give $100. $100 line. I'm not saying that line.
Mm-hmm.
And then you know how they would keep going down lower and lower, and they wouldn't get no lower than a certain number anyway. So I was like, dang, well, y'all gonna let us who only had $1 go? Well, you ain't called my number. So I knew I would be giving a higher amount, and I would purposely get in the smaller amount.
Uh-huh.
$20 with a $50 bill in my hand, sitting there in the $20 line.
Mm-hmm.
Why? You don't really know what I'm giving?
That's right.
God sees what I'm doing.
Amen.
And because God sees what I'm doing, when I do this thing in secret, He's going to reward me openly.
Amen.
That's why the blessings of the Lord make rich and add no sorrow. When you do something in the right spirit.
That's the truth.
Do it in the right spirit. I give because I want to. Mm-hmm. Some people give because they want their name blasted.
Amen.
Right. Keep your little recognition. That's as right. God sees it, that's enough for me.
Amen.
Amen. You got this blowing on whistles and let no balloons fall out from the sky. This is the 40th anniversary of you giving $500 every service. Why we got to make over that type of stuff?
It's true.
Amen.
Very true.
But you see how it started declining.
Mm-hmm.
Yep. You don't get that little spotlight.
Yep.
Start declining. But you know what? God will always take care of his people.
Yes, he will.
God will always look at the results of what's going on. And those that are humble enough and love God enough to continue on, God will bless them people abundantly.
Mm-hmm.
I'm telling you, you ain't got to sit there and brag about what you're giving. Let God speak for you.
Amen.
See, it's one thing when you speak for yourself. It's another thing when God speaks for you.
Mm-hmm.
Amen. When God speaks for you, he's going to show everybody that you bless.
Amen.
Amen. God will reward you openly, and everybody will see it.
Amen.
Amen. Let's finish this up, brother.
Charity envieth not.
It envieth not.
Charity vaunteth not itself.
Charity does love, does not envy people.
Yep.
It don't envy people. It don't sit there and look at a person and mugs them and look them up and down. Envying people. If somebody look good, some of them look good.
Amen. That's right.
But you let them say, oh, you think you all that.
Mm-hmm. Just stare.
Who you think you is in that outfit? Oh, you must think you something.
Mm-hmm.
Why gotta go through all that? It's all right to go say, sister, you look good in that outfit.
Mm-hmm.
Brother, you look nice in that suit.
Amen.
They ain't gonna take nothing from you.
Amen.
Look at that person. Oh, they come stepping out here looking like that. Mm-hmm. Oh, they prideful. You know? Let me try to use scripture. Proud look. They prideful.
Yeah.
Because you're envious. All you have to do is say, sister, mother, you look nice.
Mm-hmm.
You ain't sinning. Say, you look nice. Amen. You look good.
Mm-hmm.
Rejoice. Envying people, you know.
It's the truth. The
word of the Lord said what?
Charity vaunted not itself.
It vaunted not itself.
Is not puffed up.
It's not puffed up.
Do it not behave itself unseemly.
That's a big one. Mm. And don't behave itself unseemly.
Amen.
Seek it not her own.
And seek it not her own.
Is not easily provoked.
It's not easily provoked.
My Lord.
Think it no evil.
And don't think evil stuff.
Mm-hmm. Rejoice it not in iniquity.
And don't rejoice in iniquity. Mm-hmm.
But rejoice it in
truth. And only rejoice in truth.
Bear it all things.
It bears all things.
Believe it all
things. It believes all things.
Hope it all
things. And it hopes in all things.
Endure it all
things. It endures all things.
Mm-hmm.
Charity never fails.
Charity never fails.
But whether there be prophecy.
If there be prophecy.
They shall fail.
They shall fail.
Whether there be tongues.
If there be tongues.
They shall see.
They shall see.
Whether there be knowledge.
If there be knowledge.
It shall vanish
it
away.
It shall vanish away.
Yeah.
For we know in part.
For we know in part.
And we prophesy
in part.
But when that which,
but is, when that which is perfect has come.
My then Lord. That which is
then
in part,
that which is in part
shall be done,
shall
away.
Be done away with.
When I was a child.
When I was a child.
I spake as
I
a
spake
child.
As a child.
I understood.
I
as
understood.
A child.
As a child.
I thought as a
I
child.
I thought as a child.
But when I became a
but
man.
But when I became a man.
I put away childish.
I put away childish things.
For now we see through a glass.
But now we see through a glass.
Dark. But then face to face.
But when we see Jesus.
Oh,
now
yes.
I know in part.
My
when
Lord.
When we see Jesus.
My Lord.
If you think. If you think you know everything now,
Jesus,
there's nothing for you to know. But when we see Jesus, we shall be known. We shall know even as we are known.
My Lord.
When we see Jesus, God's going to reveal everything
yes.
to us.
Yes. No
if
doubt.
Something that we don't know, we're going to find
right.
out.
Right. No doubt.
Why was the purpose of this? Why was the purpose of that? This is why we're living. In order that we can see Jesus
mm-hmm.
and to find out those mysterious things
mm-hmm.
that don't nobody else know, that lies only in the hands of God. He said what?
But then face to face.
Then face to face.
Now I know in part.
Now I know in part.
Mm-hmm. But then shall I know
even. Then shall I know
Even as I am known.
Mm-hmm. How does God know me? He knows everything about me. Yeah. Then and only then will we know everything.
That's right.
Amen. That's why it even pays for us in the church to come down off of our high horses.
Yes,
though God has illuminated our understanding, we know that Jesus Christ is our God. We know the oneness of God. We know who the Father is. We know who the Son is. We know about the Holy Ghost. We know about the understanding of the baptism in the name of Jesus Christ, the Holy Ghost speaking in tongues. We know standards, rules, and regulations that should not make us think we know everything.
Amen. Amen.
Even that little bit only allows us to know a little bit.
That's right.
That little bit of glimpse of truth that he has given unto us is not everything.
No.
It is so much more to know about God.
Mm-hmm.
So much more to know about the ways of God. And half of us are only scratching the surface.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
We have not even digged down deep into the deep things of God yet.
My Lord.
It's funny to me how certain church folks be acting like they so deep. They act like they so deep. And they walking around in shallow water.
My Lord.
Walking around in shallow water. I go to half of these churches. And the stuff they be preaching, I'm sitting there looking like y'all only got that far.
My Lord.
You only got this far. You only are scratching the surface.
Mm-hmm. Amen.
But when it comes to the knowledge of God, there's so much more to know.
Amen. That's the truth.
We can never be arrogant in the truth that we possess like we got it all.
Nope.
When there's so much more of God to know, God is constantly revealing stuff.
Yeah, yeah.
God is constantly showing stuff. There's things that I say one day that I have to look back and God show me something else about it 3, 4, 5 days later.
Amen. That's the truth.
Now I have to add to whatever I said over here because God done showed me something else.
Mm-hmm, mm-hmm.
Or I'm listening to somebody preach, and while they're preaching, it adds a different level of understanding to me.
Amen.
And I'm sitting there saying, wow, I never saw it that way.
That's right.
But the way that the angle that they hit it from even opens up my understanding.
Mm-hmm.
Amen. That's why we can never be conceited and think we know everything.
No,
we
can't.
All right? Even though we've been graced with this truth, there's still more for us to know.
Mm-hmm.
All right? Close the book, brother. Close the book. God, I wanted to get back to Ezekiel 7 and 8, but I'll leave that for a later time.
Aww.
But what we're dealing with and what God was saying in that passage of scripture, in chapter number 7, he dealt with the natural children of Israel.
Mm-hmm.
The world around them. Verse number, see, you done walked off. That's why you never leave your post. Just because I told you to close the book.
Mm-hmm.
That's because I told you to close the book. Don't mean walk off and go get ready to do something else. Because I need Ezekiel the 8th chapter real quick.
Mm-hmm.
All right, Ezekiel the 8th chapter. I want to show something. Since I got a little bit of 7, let me get a little bit of 8.
Thank you, Lord.
All right, let me get a little bit of 8 because a little bit of 8 exposes a different dimension.
My Lord.
7 dealt with the world all around, but 8 deals with a particular group of people.
My Lord.
Chapter number 8. Ezekiel chapter number 8. Begin at verse number 1.
And it came to pass. In the sixth year. In the sixth month. In the fifth day of the month. As I sat in my house.
And the elders of Judah sat before me.
That the hand of the Lord God.
Fell thereupon me.
My Lord.
Then I beheld. And lo.
A likeness as the appearance of fire.
From the appearance of his loins even downward.
Fire.
And from his loins upward. As the appearance of brightness. As the color of amber.
Mm-hmm.
And he put forth the form of a hand.
My Lord.
And took me by a lock of my head.
Jesus.
And the Spirit lifted me up.
Between the earth and heaven.
Jesus.
And brought me in the visions of God.
And he put me into a vision.
My Lord.
Now what was transpiring according to Ezekiel was literally happening to him. The presence of God appears before him and the elders, picks him up and takes him into the spirit.
My Lord.
Takes him to the spirit and places him in a vision.
Jesus.
That's what I tell you, when God starts dealing with us spiritually, that which happens spiritually will manifest in the physical.
Mm-hmm. Amen.
It's time for the Lord to show me stuff in plain daylight. No vision, nothing. Right here.
Amen. Amen.
Right in living color.
Yeah.
God will manifest it physically.